heart of our automation innovation is something we call MySQL Autopilot. So MySQL Autopilot is machine learning-based automation. Building MySQL Autopilot required innovation from the ground up. Okay, for one thing, it's great that we get access to real-time metrics, you know, but it's a lot of data, right? So we need to sample. And to sample well for a machine learning application requires a lot of sophistication. So we've developed sophisticated adaptive sampling algorithms to extract data from all those real-time metrics and feed it into the ML pipeline. We need to extract statistics, you know, from that data that we've adaptively sampled. And we do that using proprietary algorithms we developed over many years in Oracle Labs and as part of the MySQL HeatWave project. We have something called Oracle AutoML. Now, I'll talk more about that in a minute, but Oracle AutoML is a technology that lets us master the machine learning process. You know, machine learning is not an easy thing to do well. I mean, it's for a lot of people, it's more of an art than a science. And, you know, we couldn't possibly make that work in something like MySQL HeatWave. Finally, we need to make the service-like lifecycle of MySQL HeatWave be data and workload-driven. We need to use that machine learning insight to actually drive, you know, provisioning and other parts of MySQL HeatWave. If you look at MySQL Autopilot, it's broken up into two basic kinds of behaviors that it has. First, it advises. So for things like provisioning nodes, how many nodes did you provision? It gives you advice. It also advises on where to place data. So among those nodes, how should you actually arrange the data, right? It also advises on encoding. So, you know, in MySQL HeatWave, you have more than one choice on how to represent a given kind of value. And MySQL Autopilot helps you choose. Now, this is all advice. You can override MySQL Autopilot. You don't have to take the advice. But generally speaking, you're best served if you do. It does a very good job. The other thing it does is you just fully automate certain operations. You never see it. So for one thing, it can notice if a node is misbehaving and needs to be reprovisioned. It can also tune query execution. So it observes and watches, you know, your queries running to understand, you know, how resources are being consumed. So it can execute that query faster, but also other queries that consume the same resources. And we'll talk more about that later. What HeatWave does with MySQL Autopilot is advise you on exactly how many nodes is best for your application. And it does this not only at looking at your data, your schema, the volume of data, also looking at the queries, because the queries that you run dramatically affect which you know, number of nodes is the best choice for your application. So, you know, we've tested this against some benchmarks, and we've tested this using real live customers currently using MySQL HeatWave, right? And you can see, if we predict the amount of memory that you should consume, not just to hold your data, but to execute your queries most efficiently, right? And it turns out that the amount of memory that we can predict for your application and your queries is very accurate. So in the case of TCPH, you see it's like 98%, 97%. In case of those customer workloads, very similar, 98%, 97%. Because we can correctly predict how much memory you need, not only for your data and memory, but also all the intermediate results of all of the queries you're executing, we can tell you with very high accuracy what is the best number of nodes to have in MySQL HeatWave. So MySQL Autopilot advises you on how to place your data. Again, not just looking at your data, but also looking at your queries. I mean, I think most DBAs, what they do, first guess, is they try to just partition based on keys. It's usually a decent guess. It's not usually the best guess, though, right? And you can see that when we run benchmarks. So here we have TCPH. We're comparing TCPH partitioning based on keys versus partitioning based on the advice from MySQL Autopilot. And you see a dramatic improvement, 37% and 25%. Dramatic improvements in performance achieved by just running MySQL Autopilot to get advice. Now, you know, that's not only are you going to get better runtime, but, you know, think about all the time that you or your DBA spend trying to tune and optimize data placement. Instead, you could just let MySQL Autopilot do it for you. Now, I mentioned that MySQL Autopilot can improve runtime performance for queries. Well, I think a lot of databases do that, right? I mean, they look at statistics, they gather statistics even when a query runs, and next time you run the same query, maybe you get a better result. MySQL Autopilot is different. We gather statistics from each part of the query, and we apply that to other queries. So in the query on the left, if you're not familiar with that kind of notation, we're joining together three tables, A, B, and C. Okay, and the query on the right, we're joining together A and B, but now we're unioning with another table, D. MySQL Autopilot is able to use what it learns in that first query, query one, A joined with B joined with C, and apply it to query number two and improve the performance of query number two. Now, this makes a huge difference. MySQL Autopilot improves the performance of TCPH and TCPDS by 40%. So just by turning on this query optimization to learn from one query and applying it to another, MySQL Autopilot improves performance by 40%. I mean, that's big. Well, MySQL Autopilot includes auto-scheduling. It predicts the execution time for queries and uses that to do something smarter than just a FIFO queue. It prioritizes short queries over long queries. It doesn't allow starvation. I mean, you don't have to worry about that. Okay, but what it does mean is that the interactive parts of your application, the web pages that you're presenting driven by data from MySQL HeatWave, those users are going to be a lot happier. So here's some data showing what happened when we used MySQL Autopilot auto-scheduling with TCPH. Now, some of the queries are very short, okay? And those queries, their elapsed time shrank by 45%. So the short queries that correspond to interactive screens in an application, they finished 45% faster. That's great. Now, there's no free lunch. If you speed up some queries, some other queries are going to run a little slower. So the long queries, they slowed down by 6%. But if what you're doing is you're trading off, interactive experience of your customers, interactive experience of your internal users versus, reports running a little slower, I think we'd all pick, let's make the users happy. Now that we can do MySQL Autopilot, the question is, let's turn to scale. Can we manage even more data with MySQL HeatWave than before? The answer is definitely yes. For one important aspect of scale out is ability to load data. So when you have an analytics engine sitting next to MySQL engine, now in MySQL HeatWave, they're exactly the same database. It's the same data, it's just mirrored in the analytics engine as compared to the OLTP database, right? And so when we move data into the analytics engine, that can take a while. Maybe to fill a large MySQL analytics engine, a large HeatWave analytics engine next to MySQL OTP, it might take hours, literally hours, just because the volume of data is so huge, right? And the data has to be transformed to an in-memory representation that HeatWave can query very efficiently. Now, one thing that we've added now to MySQL HeatWave is the ability to store that data, the data that we formatted into the HeatWave format, store that into Object Store. Object Store is an OCI service. Now, when we do error recovery for a node, like the node has to be restarted, we don't have to now reload the data from the MySQL OLTP instance. If we have a total crash of the cluster, then every single node has to be reloaded. They all can in parallel load from OCI Object Store that data, which has already been put in the right format. And just to give you some idea about the difference, right? So, in one of our OCI data centers, we've tested, basically loading the original load into the HeatWave format took 7 hours. We can now do it in 4 minutes. That's a dramatic improvement in performance. It's quite important when you think about availability. If something bad happens, and it doesn't happen very often, but it could happen, we can recover from that crash very quickly now. Now, we currently only use that technique for error recovery, but we're working to add it to just restarting the instance or upgrading the instance or just reloading the data. Now, MySQL HeatWave has always been secure. When we released the product, MySQL HeatWave, it stored the data encrypted at rest. It was never stored unencrypted. Now, inside the MySQL HeatWave system, though, I mean, various nodes and various pieces of the implementation, they talk to each other over the network. So, you know, the nodes and HeatWave analytics engine talk to each other. The OLTP engine talks to the analytics engine over network. You know, that was not encrypted, right? Well, now everything in MySQL HeatWave is encrypted. So as the data moves across the network, it is encrypted. As the data sits in any kind of persistent store, it is encrypted. So your data in MySQL HeatWave is now always encrypted. Now, when we first announced and first released MySQL HeatWave, we had very good scalability. And you can see that on the bottom line, right? So you can see that as you add nodes to the original MySQL HeatWave, I got a little bit better than 80% of that node's capacity, and it was pretty flat. Not perfectly flat, but pretty flat. MySQL HeatWave is now much better. So not only can we scale up to more nodes, all the way up to 64 nodes, but the scalability is now 0.89. So that means that as I add nodes to my cluster, I get to take advantage of 0.89 of the capacity of that node, adding it to the efficiency of my overall system. Now, you know, we did some updates. You know, when we first launched MySQL HeatWave, we did some benchmarks against Redshift, and we talked about those back in December. Well, we've now benchmarked our most recent version of MySQL HeatWave against their most recent version of Redshift Aqua. Well, we're now 13 times better price performance, up from 7 times. So we went from 7 times better price performance to 13 times better price performance. 6.8 times faster at half the cost. You get more performance with MySQL HeatWave. And now with the recent innovations, you know, performance is even better. We're now going to compare ourselves to Snowflake. We are much better than Snowflake. 35 times better price performance to Snowflake. I mean, if you thought 13x or 17x price performance advantage over Redshift was big, we are 35 times better than Snowflake in terms of price performance. Now, the cost you see on the right is compared using list price. Their list price, our list price. We have to use list prices because Snowflake doesn't publish, they don't publish a discount schedule. You know, there's no way to know like what kind of volume discounting you may or may not get with Snowflake. You can get a discount from them. You can get a discount from us. But I guarantee you, there is no level of discount they're going to be willing to offer you to make up for a 35 times price performance gap. Now, let's look at a collection of databases you're likely to choose from all together on one slide. MySQL HeatWave is by far faster and cheaper than Redshift, than Synapse, than Snowflake, than Google BigQuery. I mean, we've already compared ourselves multiple times to Redshift. You've seen that. Well, you know, when you compare ourselves to Azure, what we find is Azure is a little bit worse than Redshift. Snowflake is a lot worse. Google is even more bad. Even Google BigQuery is terrible. MySQL HeatWave has by far the best price performance of any of these competitors. We're faster and we're cheaper. And by the way, this slide understates our price performance advantage. All the comparisons that I did before, we didn't account for one very important thing, that when you use MySQL HeatWave, you're getting OLTP and query performance together. You're not having to pay for a separate OLTP instance and a separate analytics instance. When we do a price performance comparison to Redshift, somewhere there's an OLTP database that's generating that data that you're loading into Redshift. The same for Synapse, the same for Snowflake, the same for Google BigQuery. So the true price performance advantage of MySQL HeatWave is much better than we've shown. Running 100 gigabyte CH benchmark with 4 concurrent OLAP sessions, our latency is 18 times lower than Aurora. Right? If you want to think about, hey, what if I just use Aurora instead of using MySQL HeatWave? Because, you know, I got to run transactions. I can't use Redshift. Well, if you run CH benchmark on your database application comparing Aurora and MySQL HeatWave, MySQL HeatWave has 18 times better latency. Throughput, 110 times better throughput. I mean, if 18 times is great for latency, throughput 110 times better for HeatWave. Aurora not looking too good for CH benchmark. How about the cost? Well, if you want to run with 18 times better latency, 110 times better throughput. You also have to pay 60% less, 60% less for MySQL HeatWave. We've added innovation using MySQL Autopilot. You know, automation driven by machine learning specific to your instance gives you a better experience and gives you much better performance. We've added more scale. You can now scale up MySQL HeatWave to 64 nodes, managing 32 terabytes of data. And the scalability has improved by 20%. So our scalability is 0.89. I mean, that's an amazing thing across all those nodes. The price performance of MySQL HeatWave is now even better than it was before based on these innovations. And I think if you look at MySQL HeatWave and compare it to any other service that you're considering using, MySQL HeatWave is by far the best choice. Thank you.